Are you ready to explore a classic TV series filled with funny, shocking, and even sad moments? If so, keep watching because you're in for a treat. Today, we're diving into a beloved 1960s show called My Three Sons. The show follows a widower named Steve Douglas as he raises his three sons, Mike, Robbie, and Chip. Each episode is packed with heartwarming family moments, hilarious mishaps, and unexpected twists that keep viewers hooked. But what makes My Three Sons so enduring? Is there a scene or moment that sticks with you? Maybe it's the family themes that make it special. Now, we want to hear from you. What's your favorite memory or experience with this classic TV series? Share your stories below. We'd love to hear from you. So, grab your popcorn and get ready for a trip down memory lane with My Three Sons. And remember, there are plenty of interesting facts waiting to be uncovered, so keep watching. In the lively world of 1960s TV, one show stood out for its family charm and relatable humor. Imagine a time when black and white TVs were common and families gathered for good TV. Enter My Three Sons, a sitcom that made its mark on the era. Picture a busy family led by widowed father Steve Douglas, played by Fred McMurray. The show follows Steve raising three sons, Mike, Robbie, and Chip, with the help of their friendly housekeeper, Uncle Charlie. My Three Sons showed the American family experience in the 1960s. It connected with viewers who loved the relatable challenges and heartwarming moments. The characters became part of viewers' lives, making the show special. The show wasn't just funny, it also explored societal norms and family values of the time. In the chaotic 60s, My Three Sons offered a comforting break into the Douglas family's lives. As the first show with a widowed father as the main character, My Three Sons was groundbreaking. It inspired future shows about families, making it a leader in sitcoms. The impact of My Three Sons continues even today. Its charm lies in its simplicity, appealing to audiences of all ages. In classic TV, My Three Sons shows the timeless appeal of family stories. It's a reminder of a time when TV blended laughter and life lessons. Following Don Grady's departure from the show, plans for Robbie, his character, took a different turn. There were considerations of either having Robbie and Katie go through a divorce or opting for the character's demise. For the initial 7 seasons, the production of the series unfolded at DeZillou Studios. However, with the sale of DeZillou to Paramount, the filming hub transitioned to CBS Studio City. This shift in location also meant the on-screen family had to relocate to California. Fast forward to 2018, and Barry Livingston stands as the sole surviving regular cast member actively involved in the Screen Actors Guild. In summary, post-Grady era brought potential plot twists for Robbie's character, and the show's geographical filming location underwent a significant change with the shift from DeZillou Studios to CBS Studio City. Barry Livingston remains the lone surviving regular cast member, continuing his involvement in the Screen Actors Guild. When Ernie officially joined the Douglas family by adoption, his life changed a lot. But there was something strange that happened during this time. His dear dog, Wilson, suddenly disappeared, and nobody knew why. On the show, he acted alongside his real-life brother Barry Livingston, playing the roles of siblings in a very genuine and charming way. However, it was his role as Steve Douglas that really made people love him. He became very famous because of it and will always be remembered for his work on television. My Three Sons featured real-life brothers Stanley Livingston, who played Chip, and Barry Livingston, who portrayed Ernie. The exterior set for the main house was Melody Ranch's barn with additional features. After William Frawley and Tim Considine departed, Bub and Mike's characters were largely forgotten, with no direct mention of Bub and only occasional indirect references to Mike. Similarly, Ernie's adoption into the Douglas family was never brought up as the series progressed. My Three Sons stands out for surviving a network switch during its run. In the 1965-1966 season, the show successfully moved from ABC to CBS, where it continued for its final 7 seasons. Interestingly, the Brady Bunch later borrowed storylines from My Three Sons for several episodes. Episodes like Catch You, inspired by a plot from My Three Sons, and The Winner, drawing from another episode, showcase the influence and reuse of storylines between the two series. Two Peats in a Pod also echoes a plot from My Three Sons. Notably, Eddie Albert turned down the lead role in My Three Sons, a decision that could have changed the show's dynamic. Instead, he focused on his film career and later found success on Green Acres. In summary, the show defied expectations by surviving a network transition and had an impact on television, even influencing later series like The Brady Bunch. Eddie Albert's decision also shaped the course of the show. My Three Sons aired in the 1960s. The theme song resembled a family band with a rhythm part played like chopsticks, symbolizing a child's skill level. The lead melody, played on saxophone by Fred McMurray, represented the father. McMurray, during the sixth season, starred in Follow Me, Boys, as a saxophone player turned scoutmaster. Tramp the Dog, named after a character from Lady and the Tramp, was a notable part of the show. Additionally, Fred McMurray taught his future co-star Beverly Garland how to play golf. My Three Sons aired from 1960 to 1972. Charlie, brother of Bub, was a character in the show. The theme song, featuring a saxophone melody over chopsticks, showcased Fred McMurray's skill as a saxophonist who played in big bands early in his career. McMurray, playing the dad, had a dream contract allowing him to work just 65 days a year on the series. Consequently, the supporting cast often filmed scenes with a prop person in place of Fred. The series enjoyed 12 successful seasons. My Three Sons, a TV series that debuted in 1960, is noted for its distinctive theme music. The closed captions describe the show's theme music as swanky orchestral music and the opening scene theme as jaunty woodwind music. The series, which initially aired on ABC, later moved to CBS. The shift occurred because ABC declined to finance the higher cost of filming in color. A noteworthy aspect of the show is the filming method employed, which was out of sequence. This approach contrasted with the sequential filming method used in I Love Lucy for many years. The lead actor, having previously worked on I Love Lucy, never felt comfortable with the non-sequential filming used in My Three Sons. In summary, My Three Sons stands out for its distinctive theme music, the transition from ABC to CBS due to color filming costs, and the discomfort of the lead actor with the out-of-sequence filming method. My Three Sons aired for 12 years, boasting 369 episodes, making it the second longest-running comedy in US TV history after The Adventures of Ozzie and Harriet. Don Grady once compared William Damaris to William Frawley, stating that while both were curmudgeons, Frawley was more humorous and Damaris was simply grouchy. The tension between them was evident during the transition from Bub to Uncle Charlie, as they were longtime showbiz rivals. Interestingly, the role of Steve Douglas wasn't the producer's first choice. It went to Fred McMurray after Eddie Albert declined to focus on his movie career. June Haver, Fred McMurray's real-life wife, recommended Beverly Garland for the role of Barbara. He was awarded a star on the Hollywood Walk of Fame at 16667 Hollywood Boulevard in Hollywood, California. Upon his arrival at this event, Mr. Damaris greeted the public with a cheerful hello, folks. Cast members from the TV series attending this event included Fred McMurray, Stanley Livingston, Barry Livingston, and Tina Cole. Even though Don Grady left the series after season 11, his name remained in the opening credits in the 12th and final season.